Hi there! Welcome back to the Weird Side of YouTube. This is Casual Fridays, which, as you know, is Pajama Day. And today, I wanted to talk about things that I'm excited about. As you may or may not have noticed, I took a break from YouTube, a small break for about a week. I had sketchbook tour videos scheduled to premiere, and I had a couple of storytime videos scheduled to premiere. But I just wasn't feeling it. I needed to take a break for my mental health. And you'll notice that the Sims videos of the controversial challenge that I was doing have since been deleted. I know I said that I didn't want to delete them because there's an important storyline for that character that I was using. But when I sat down to play and continue her storyline, the entire experience has been tainted for me. So, and I don't just mean recording or continuing with that character, I mean playing the entire game. So I don't know when I'll be able to continue playing The Sims, hopefully soon, but as of right now, just thinking about it makes me sick. So I wanted to take the time today to talk about things that I do enjoy and talk about things that I'm excited about. So let's get started. The first thing I wanted to talk about is how excited I am for the Disney live-action Little Mermaid. I think the casting choices they have done are phenomenal. I think they are perfect. I'm especially excited to see Halle Bailey play Ariel because she looks exactly like her to me.
Unforgettable, lonely awful.
She has the same facial features and everything. It's just uncanny to me. I love it.
And I could be part of your world.
As you can tell, I'm a big Little Mermaid fan. I have an Ariel blanket right here. If you know me, you know why I love Little Mermaid so much. She had a lot to do with my coming out story.
Part of your
I'm just really excited for that movie, and I really hope that I can go to theaters to see it. Another thing that I wanted to talk about is WandaVision.
But what is grief, if not love, persevering?
Now, I know it's weird to say that you're excited about a show that you've already watched completely, but WandaVision has got to be the coolest, most unique television show experience that I have ever had. It is amazing, and is without a doubt my favorite Marvel anything that they've ever done. I'm not a huge Marvel fan. I've seen a handful of the movies, not all of them, because there's like 30. But before this, my favorite Marvel thing was Captain Marvel. I thought that was a really cool thing. I really appreciated the 90s throwback references, the music, the soundtrack, everything. I thought Captain Marvel was cool. And before that, I had just watched a handful of the actual Avengers movies. But WandaVision is something outside of the normal superhero spectrum that I did not expect Marvel to do. It's usually DC that delves into, like, emotions and, like, the camaraderie between superheroes and the what it means to be a hero and a human at the same time, but they do it in a much darker way. WandaVision is an amalgamation of things that I personally love. It is dark, but it's also kid-friendly and Disney-esque, obviously, because it's made by Disney. There's witches in it. Theme of, like, old sitcoms and modern sitcoms, because it goes through the timeline of different kinds of sitcoms. And this show when I tell you, it made me cry so many times. There's so many cool characters in it. I'm excited about Monica Rambeau and what she's going to be doing in the Marvel Universe. This is the first time that I've been invested in the Marvel Universe since its inception. This is just the coolest thing they have ever done, and I am super happy about it. And yes, Wanda Maximoff, the Scarlet Witch, is now my favorite superhero. She has taken the place of Raven from Teen Titans. I know. It's crazy. But Wanda, the Scarlet Witch, is now my favorite superhero. Another thing I wanted to talk about is Doom Patrol.
What the fuck is the Doom Patrol?
Now, Doom Patrol has been a show for a while. I think it was going to be a spinoff of Titans, the new gritty live-action show about Teen Titans, but it's not Teen Titans, it's just Titans. It's darker and a lot cussier, which I liked a lot because I just love the characters of, like, Raven, Beast Boy, all the classics. Starfire and Titans, I don't know her name, but whoever they cast to be her is Starfire to me. I cannot imagine Starfire without her face anymore. And this is coming from a Teen Titans animated series fan. So, I hate it when people are like, you can't play a character because you're black. Back to Halle Bailey from Live Action Little Mermaid casting. I don't understand that. A, Ariel's a mermaid. She can be any color she wants. Any color anyone wants writing about her. B, Starfire is an alien, and her power comes from the sun, and it just makes sense to me in my mind, because black people have melanin. They would have sun powers. It just makes sense to me. But that's neither here nor there. That's just an opinion. Doom Patrol is its own continuity separate from Titan. And, it took a few episodes for me to get into it, but I love, Jane, the character of Jane. I don't like calling her Crazy Jane because I don't like that word. I've had people use that word on me a few times and I was not pleased about it. And I love the character of Larry, but my favorite character is Rita. Rita is my everything. She is literally a female version of my fiance in everything she does and says, and she is just perfect in every way, and I love the actress that plays her because she was also in Drop Dead Diva as the best friend, and I think the writing for her is incredible, and I'm very pleased with it. I'm excited to get the second season. My fiance just ordered it from Amazon on DVD, and we are very, very excited to watch it. Another thing I'm really excited about is World of Warcraft.
Look around you!
I know, I'm excited about these old things that everyone else has been into forever, but that's just my life. I'm really, really into Warcraft right now. The only game that I play right now is Warcraft. I have so many characters, a lot of which I'm going to be introducing you all to soon. My favorite character right now is a demon hunter named Sedominator, and he is just the best. I love his leather outfit. I gave him a leather harness and a leather eye patch, and he's just beautiful in every way. So. Something else that I'm excited about is not a piece of media, it is the fact that I'm probably going to get a new computer to play Warcraft on. And then, this is a big one, I'm going to start playing more games for you guys. I'm going to start playing games that I love because I'm shifting this channel to things that I love passionately, and I'm trying to live a life where if I'm not passionate about it, I don't want it. If it's just kind of meh, I don't need it. And I think that's important for everyone to do, but especially for me, because I've kind of surrounded myself with assholes and things that I don't like my whole life. So, yeah, I'm kind of taking control back now, and I'm really excited about that as well. Full circle. Very excited about my new computer. I'm going to start playing... Oh, I'm so excited. I know for sure I want to play Donkey Kong Country 1, 2, and 3, which are on Super Nintendo. And I know for sure that I want to play Yoshi's Island that was on Super Nintendo. I really want to go back and play these games that made me super happy as a kid, because I know it's going to make me super happy now. And I also want to play Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie, and I also want to play this really silly game called Crystal's Ponytail that I had on Sega Genesis. It wasn't a very good game. It was very A to B to C, kind of basic, but the music in it and the pretty ponies just made me super happy at the time, and I feel like I want that kind of pretty energy on my channel. So I definitely want to play that as well. As for Kingdom Hearts and the Legend of Zelda games, I'm probably going to play Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask, and Kingdom Hearts 1, 2, Chain of Memories, definitely, because those games are my favorites. Chain of Memories is still my favorite Kingdom Hearts game, and every time I say tell that to someone, they think that I'm lying. But I'm not. It's the first one I played, in my opinion, even though it's not really Riku. There's so many So Riku moments in there. It just makes me really happy, that game. And it was cute on my Game Boy. It was the cutest thing I had on my Game Boy, and it made me really happy. I am excited about you guys. I'm excited to be returning to the weird side of YouTube. I'm excited to be, I'm excited to have had a break, and I'm excited to come back, you know, raring to go. I'm just really excited to be back, and I hope you guys are excited to see me back. You might have not even noticed that I was gone, because some videos were still uploading. But I was indeed taking a break from all social media. This series is about me just chatting with you guys very casually about anything and everything. If you guys have any requests of things that you want to know about me, like things from my past or things that I want to do or my plans or anything like that, feel free to ask questions and I will get to it in this series right here. Please like and subscribe. Theodore would really appreciate it. I would really appreciate it. I'd really appreciate it, but I'd also really just appreciate just you watching it, especially if you got all the way to the end. I don't have many people that listen to me like this, and I really appreciate it. So, I love you guys, and I will see you guys next time.